Yeah.
I don't know what's happening. If you're heading out today and driving on the highways and the byways and the roads, be careful because...
Yeah. Well, MnDOT will often say, hey, icy conditions, you know, be aware. Here's what we're seeing out there. But we had nothing like that.
I think it was just a weird morning.
Man, yeah. So many crashes this morning.
MnDOT's in... Every police officer's got to supposed to report that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Like, why was there an accident?
Yeah.
So to have all these, it must just be dumb luck.
I don't know. It's a weird morning. Just I'm gonna do a little more research on this. But
yeah.
When I drove in this morning, it was fine. I don't know about you guys.
Roads are dry. Yeah.
Yeah.
Came down and everything.
No, it was all good. It's just a weird morning.
I guess.
Stay off your phones if you're heading out.
Yeah,
stay off your phones.
Yeah, there was a ton of accidents.
Don't eat breakfast while you're driving. Don't put on your makeup. I've seen people.
That's exactly what I do though in the morning. So
eating breakfast and putting on your makeup.
Yes. Nobody's on the
all
road.
All of the above.
I mean, I guess.
I am kidding.
Yeah.
I never do that.
Never.
I drive in at 1:30 in the morning. I'm just saying.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a different time.
It's true. There's nobody on the roads. So when I come in, it's free and clear the entire way. Mm-hmm. So.
Yeah. That is one perk to waking up as early as.
Actually, it's kind of. Sometimes I like needing to focus a little bit more.
Oh, really?
I don't like it sometimes. I have a long drive in.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But,
is it, what, 40? 45?
Yeah, 45.
That's long. Oof.
If it's slick, it's like an hour and a half.
Yeah.
Like, what, it was an October morning. It took me 2 hours to get here.
Oh, my
horrible.
Gosh.
Because I got a live show at 4:30, and I was like, I think I showed up like 4:15. I was like,
Hey, you know what? Viewers would never be able to tell. You get on air, and you're smiling, and they don't know what you've just been through
right.
on the road.
Just built everything during the show. I don't know how we got to that, but
yeah.
Driving stinks. I get very like, I got to do something.
Yeah, listen to a podcast or something.
I can never do a rush hour commute. The people that, I mean, God bless you for, you know, doing a 9 to 5 and coming home. I could not do that schedule because sitting in traffic on these highways would just drive me crazy every
kind
evening.
Of spoiled, aren't
yeah,
we?
Yeah, we are very spoiled.
In a little way, you know. We have to wake up early, but we don't have to deal with
the traffic.
That is the one
sleep.
Thing.
Yeah.
I never have to look at like where I'm living or in the city or anything like that because it literally doesn't matter.
Yeah.
I could live in Chicago, it wouldn't matter. Because it doesn't, the traffic, we literally drive at the exact time when there is never traffic.
Right.
It's a beautiful thing.
It's one perk.
Speaking of something that's not beautiful.
No.
Let's talk about this. And you have experience with this, and I want you to give your perspective on this.
I mean, I was young.
You were young, but the memory still lingers,
was
right?
10.
Yeah.
So I guess I was old enough.
All you Vikings fans out there may remember this. 25 years ago today, the worst day, some are calling it, in Minnesota pro sports history. So let's set the stage. January 17th. 1999, it was the NFC Championship game. Who are they playing?
Atlanta.
Atlanta. Trip to the Super Bowl on the line.
It's a guaranteed Super Bowl win for the Vikings.
Seconds left in the game. Gary Anderson steps up, 38-yard field goal. Not a hard field goal. Not a chip shot either, but something he should make. He hasn't missed a field goal all season. Shanks it. Completely misses it. Costs the Vikings a trip to the Super Bowl. What do you remember about all of that?
Well, for whatever reason, I liked football more when I was a kid. Mm-hmm. It was like life or death. Like, that's what it felt like.
Right.
Well, your life is in a box, so football is like, you don't know.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm
talking
about?
You don't have all the other responsibilities in life to worry about.
I don't know tragedy yet.
Yeah,
I
suppose. And you were a ball boy, too, right, for the Vikings?
Not yet.
Oh,
that was
not
a
yet.
Year or two later.
Okay, see, I mean, that will make anyone be a huge fan, I would think.
Yeah, I was a huge, I still am, but I'm healthy now. I'm recovering.
In a much better mental space than you
recovering
were.
Recovering Vikings.
Yeah, no, it was bad. I remember I just was crying and screaming, and I told my dad I don't want to live anymore and stuff.
Oh my gosh.
It was that bad.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it was bad.
Who was on that team? I'm curious.
Randy Moss.
That was Randy
Dante
Moss.
Culpepper. Yeah. Or no, Cunningham. Chris Carter.
Oh, that's a good team.
It was the dream team. It was Robert Smith. It was like an all-time. That was the best team. That's the best team to ever not win a Super Bowl, hands down. But it was a guaranteed Super Bowl.
Mm-hmm. It was the Falcons who went instead, and they played against that Super Bowl with the Falcons.
They didn't win.
Yeah, they didn't win. Was it Denver?
Yes.
It was that John Elway team?
I think you're
I
right.
I think, yeah.
I don't even remember.
Yeah.
I just know that Atlanta didn't win. I didn't watch it.
I don't blame you. I don't blame you. Why would you want to watch after that?
I would have like 11 years old or something, 10 or 11. It was a bad time as a Vikings fan. But I thought 09 was just as bad.
What was 09?
Yeah, I'm trying to.
That was when we had Adrian Peterson, Percy Harvin, Brett Favre.
Oh.
And we were in the, at the 35-yard line to kick the game-winning field goal to go to the Super Bowl, mm-hmm. which we would have won. And because, again, the Vikings were the best team that year, too. Mm-hmm. And then we Favre threw the interception for no reason at all. It was like a minute left in the game.
Which he didn't need to because you're on the 35. You run it a couple times and kick it.
Yeah, just in the game. And then he threw an interception for no reason at all. We lost the game. They went whoop right down the field, kicked the field goal, and we lost.
Whew. There has been some heartbreak in Minnesota sports, especially when it comes to the Vikings.
The only thing worse I can think of is the Bills, which nobody will ever top. That's why I always root for the Bills. I know you. I'm sorry.
Yeah, it is not happening here, but I get it.
Four straight Super Bowl losses is the worst.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But to make it so close, the Vikings have been so close in so many NFC Championship games over the last 20 years.
Well, like it's 2018.
Right there.
The Minneapolis Miracle didn't win the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
That team wasn't the best team, though. Mm-hmm. You don't.
I don't. Sorry. I'm like, I was just thinking, I was eight when the 25 years ago situation. I just remember the picture. I don't know if it was Star Tribune or where that photo was, but it's these three women and they just look so sad. Do you remember the picture I'm talking about?
I've never seen it. I didn't look it up, though.
Okay. It was like this kind of, I don't know.
It should be the team logo. Those three women crying. Dude, it just, it's
and they
so
all have their Vikings gear on, and they're just so sad.
It's like traumatic. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But I think the trauma brings you together. Mm-hmm. It's like a funeral, kind of. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's like we all come together as one hopeless group.
And even with all that, like the Vikings like are considered like, have one of the best fan bases in the NFL. Well, they we sell have the out best, every game.
We have the best record in Super Bowl history.
Right.
Super Bowl era history. The Vikings have the best record.
Mm-hmm. Like, they're, it's a good team with a good fan base. It just, for some reason, just can't get over that hump.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And you wonder when that's going to happen because the Packers are getting good now. The Lions are good.
Packers just win. The thing, if you look at the Vikings, like, compared to, like, the Lions or something, the Vikings are in the playoffs 3 out of 4 years for the past 50 years. Mm-hmm. We're always in the playoffs, and that's why it's so sad, because we're always there, always there, always there, never get done.
Right.
The Lions are just garbage, always.
Yeah. It's
they missed the playoffs for like 30 years. They're like, we don't make the playoffs. It's what we do.
That's their base expectation. We just don't make the playoffs. So for them to be where they are now, it's they're overjoyed.
They don't even care. Like, if they lose, they're like, this was the best season ever.
Right. They don't have that heartbreak that Vikings fans have.
Right.
I hate becoming a part of this trauma. I really do.
So does Miami has that back in the arena. It's a bad franchise.
Yeah.
It's probably one of the, I would say Miami with Marino, they never won a Super Bowl.
No, they never did.
Have they never won a Super Bowl?
No, we haven't won since 1973. So the two back-to-back, the perfect season, and then we won the year after that. Haven't won anything since. Haven't won a playoff game since the Clinton administration. Yes, it's been that long.
Oh, they're like the worst team.
And the last time we won a playoff game, it wasn't even televised in South Florida. Because back then, the NFL had a rule where if the games didn't sell out, they wouldn't broadcast it. I had to listen to it on the radio. The last playoff win for the Dolphins, I listened to on the radio because I couldn't watch it on TV. That's how long it's been. Yes, I am a grandpa. Wow. That's how long it's been.
And you remember.
And I remember. I remember listening to the radio.
Where were you?
I was in my house.
Okay.
I remember it went into overtime. It was against the Colts, and it was Lamar. Lamar Smith ran into the end zone for a touchdown. He had like 200 yards that day, won in overtime, and we got our butts kicked the next week. But it was our last playoff win, 2000, early 2000. So that was still during the Clinton administration. He was still in office at that point. So
a while ago. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, welcome to the same fan base.
Misery. Yes. Misery loves
company. This is nothing new, right?
Watch the Timberwolves just go win like a championship or something.
I hope they do.
It feels right. They'll get there and we'll lose.
I hope they do for the purposes of us and Minneapolis and our coverage here. I also am a Thunder fan, so.
Ooh, two of the best teams.
And they play this Saturday. I'm trying to be at the game.
Oh,
it's gonna be great.
Basketball games. I haven't been to a basketball game so long. I used to watch a lot of the Rubio Love years. Mm-hmm. That was like 10 years ago now. But I was really into Timberwolves.
Get out and watch the Timberwolves. They're good. They deserve the support.
Yeah, I went there. It was fun.
Yes, I have.
Basketball is so great because you're just right there. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You can actually watch the game.
And it's like a smaller arena, so it feels intimate. The seats feel close. The atmosphere is great. The fans are loud. It's a good time.
I'm with you. Football, I don't know. I like watching football at home. Hot take.
That's true.
Hot take.
You get to get up and go to the bathroom, and it's not as expensive.
No parking.
Yeah, no parking. You don't worry about all that.
It's like a 9-hour day to go to the football game. I went to the Timberwolves game. it was a quick game, 2 hours.
Yeah. In and out.
It was not packed, so you can get out of the city.
Right.
And it was fine. It was like, I think I went down there at 5:45. I was out of there by 8:45.
It's quick and efficient.
It was fun.
Football takes away your entire life. Okay. Weather, because things are getting weird here over the next week. It's a good thing you're going on your excursion this weekend.
I know. Take some pictures.
Yeah, I can't wait to hear about
it. I don't know if they have the bombardiers running because of whatever happened earlier.
The what running?
A bombardier.
I don't know what that is.
Oh, we had a whole discussion
yesterday. It's like a tank on ice.
What?
It's a tank.
Yeah, I'll find a picture.
Okay. We did this. And that's how you get to your location?
Yes.
And if it's not running, you just have to trek there yourself?
One sank on Lake of the Woods this year, and people died. So.
Okay, maybe don't go on that then.
Right. So
it's been cold, but.
The family members are like, please don't go on the bombardier.
Yeah.
And there's a little hatch up top, and I.
You're tempted.
Well, here you go.
Oh, wow.
It's one of the coolest
machines.
That's
pretty cool.
Yeah, it fits a lot of
people.
That's
not what I was expecting. Mm-hmm. It kind of looks like a retro car.
Like a VW bug,
yeah.
But extended. Yeah.
They weigh 1,000,000 pounds.
That's cool.
But they've been building ice, I've heard, like an inch a day. So I think we could drive on it. Because it was only ATVs last week, and you had to do like a little hay ride. They take it. I'm serious, they drive you, they're just freezing in the hayride all the way up to the lake.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, so they moved these sleepers out yesterday. So this is wild. I mean, this place lives off of this.
Yeah.
But I mean, the place I go to, it's like cash only.
Oh my gosh.
You know.
Be careful out there. I know you will be, but be careful out there.
I mean, I try to be like more like don't get drunk. Mm-hmm. You're in the middle of nowhere trying to get frozen to death.
Right.
I don't know.
It's a lot of really risks. Not.
It's. But I just sleep in the corner now and enjoy my life and eat some Chex Mix. It's great.
Do you catch much?
No.
Okay.
You don't go out there to catch fish.
I catch probably five walleye for the whole weekend.
Okay, but walleye are not easy to catch, so.
Well, yeah, and we eat them and I fillet them up. I'm like a fillet master.
Okay.
So they just catch them and I just slice them up.
Well, do you batter the fish or do you just straight
I do them three, four ways. So I like. I'd like a beer batter sometimes, but that's if you have less fish. So if I catch less fish but we want to eat, I'll do beer batter because it's more filling, right? But it'd be like cod, like a beer, like a nice fillet.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'll do that if we have less fish. If we have a lot of fish, you do less batter. It's just the rule. So then I'll just do like a light breading. But then I'll do like a Ritz cracker one, egg Ritz cracker, like really buttery,
cracker
flaky.
Breading. Yes.
We do that. My family does that with saltines too.
Saltines, okay.
Saltine breading. Mm-hmm. Okay, I've never heard of saltines.
Do you
Same
eat
exact
a lot of fish?
Thing. We try, but we don't catch much, so.
Does anybody ever catch?
This is a very Minnesotan conversation, I think.
Yes.
I love watching it.
But
this
I mean,
great.
Well, didn't you go fishing?
I did go
so
fishing
you know,
that one time.
You know.
Yeah. I generally had that one time.
Did you eat them?
You still have been.
Did you eat the fish or no?
No, we caught and released.
You caught bass, I think I watched it.
Yeah, bass and a couple
Nobody
other fish.
Nobody eats bass in Minnesota.
They don't?
No.
How does bass taste?
Muddy, fishy, soft.
Like catfish.
I love catfish. Though.
I do too. I breaded some catfish this past weekend.
Oh, you did?
Okay, and what kind of breading did you use?
So it was a cornmeal based breading. I discovered the joys, I was telling Alicia this, the joys of buttermilk.
Oh,
so you soak it in buttermilk for a half hour.
Oh my gosh.
Kind of gets rid of the muddy, fishy taste. Then you bread it with the cornmeal breading, throw it in some oil.
I love catfish. So
Lovely, that sounds good.
Minnesota people hate catfish. They don't eat it.
I've learned that.
So they hate catfish.
They look down on catfish.
They
don't
do.
Don't judge catfish.
It's kind of how like Minnesotans look down on like Southerners. So
they do that too.
They do, it's true. I've lived here my whole life. Like, the South. And but I used to look down at like catfish because I was just raised on walleye.
Oh, dang.
And crappies, right?
I was not. I was raised on like the easy ones to catch, sunnies.
Well, sunnies too. Sunnies are great. All of those are really clean fish. Anyways, I moved to, when I moved to Charlotte, I lived on a lake and I fished it all the time. And I started only fishing for catfish because I caught one and I was kind of scared to touch them. In Minnesota, you just cut your line. That's what I was taught. Like you just get rid of them. They're gross. They'll sting you. And then I go down there, it's like, nah, dude, these are treasured. So then I started trying to fish for channel catfish because they tasted better than blue catfish. And I was eating catfish. We probably ate catfish 4 days a week in Charlotte.
Really?
I fell in love. like, there's nothing better than catfish.
Catfish is so good with some hush puppies and some french fries.
It is so tender.
I would totally try it.
People call it mushy. I think it's tender. Mm. And it's a great white flaky fish, like a white tender fish.
Yep.
And it has, I think it has a better flavor. Mm. Hot take. That is a hot Minnesota take. It's a hot take.
Better than anything else?
It's better than walleye.
Wow.
Okay. I think so.
I haven't had walleye, or I think I've had walleye once, but it wasn't anything memorable to me. I'll take a catfish over almost any fish, except
juicier.
For like snapper. I love snapper. I love grouper.
Oh, well, yeah. Right, but would you agree? It's more like juicy.
Yes.
It's juicy.
Mm-hmm. We're gonna change your minds, Minnesota.
Because the flakiness is less juicy.
Too.
Yeah, you will.
I'll try it. I just have never had it.
Listen, the one thing I picked up in the South is I like catfish.
Catfish.
Catfish is good.
And I want to try it with the buttermilk.
Soak it in buttermilk.
Breading.
Yeah, dude. I'm all
anything
down.
With buttermilk, like buttermilk pancakes.
Buttermilk. A little bit of buttermilk in your omelet. Buttermilk in your scrambled eggs.
Oh,
buttermilk fried chicken.
That sounds lovely too.
I
think
love
I have
fried
had
chicken.
That. Yeah.
Fried chicken is a deathbed food for me. All right, we can do this. Here's your 7-day forecast.
I'm hungry.
Talking about fried, I like the fried chicken in the South
too.
Yeah,
this turned into a cooking segment.
Really,
real
the South. I hate to say this. The food in the South is better than us. All right, it is.
It is.
Sorry. There's just no way around it.
Sorry about it.
It's not even in the.
Yeah.
You can't even talk about it.
I do love a Juicy Lucy, though.
We do burgers, but everything else.
That's about it.
Yeah, that's about it. All right. Cool. 10 on Saturday. A little chilly weekend, but next week, getting slushy by
38.
Wednesday. 38, getting to 40 degrees. I'm not excited about
it. You were
that.
Saying you think green grass?
Oh, definitely.
What?
3 straight days of that and some rain.
Mm-mm-mm.
It's over.
It's over, everyone.
Hang it up. Okay. February doesn't exist.
Thank you for watching the Minnesota Fishing Report this morning.
Yeah.
Bye.